What is up, team? So, thanks very much for watching again. Sorry, I'm going to go on another ramble about random things about dieting. But at the moment, this is my segue into this week's vlog. I'm actually going to get my hair cut. So, if any of you have been watching my vlogs, Instagram, seen my photos, I have not had my hair cut in fucking 20 weeks or something. And considering I'm waiting to be 30, I've got rather fast hair growth, as you can tell by this absolute monstrosity going on my napper. So next time you see me, I'm either going to have a balder or a short back and squint or something like that. So that is what I am away to get done. Wait, sort this out. If anyone's struggling for hair at 30, sorry in advance, mate, because mine seems to keep getting fucking thicker. Now, enough of me swearing. You will see the highlights of this week on the rest of the vlog, and as I've said every week, another good drop. I'll throw in some good value for the rest of the actual vlog as well, so don't worry about that. It won't just be me chatting shit about my hair and wearing G-Way. What I'll do here is I'll do like a sweet before and after shot. So obviously, hair's done, looking good. I'll have knocked another kilo off just with a haircut. So I'll put that on as a before and after. And as I said, I will actually get into the proper vlog from now. Robin's running away up here because she's not done her makeup or something. Strange, and here's me with a nose strip on. And I'm not bald, by the way. You've seen my hair earlier. This is just, you'll be bored of me walking up this street. It's not really that exotic. When I'm back in the gym, you won't have to see that. Something I just wanted to cover is this. So it's a pretty shit morning here. It's like, temperature's okay, but it looks like it might rain. And it's not that nice. And we're about to go train legs in a garden under a gazebo. So it doesn't really stop the wind. But it's something that you could really take home from training at home or wherever you've been training, is the mindset you need to do it. Because obviously before we did take the gym for granted, but if you're in the gym and you're not going into your set thinking about what you're going to do, thinking about how many reps, etc., you're basically just fucking ticking a box, but ticking it badly. So you need to take that real focus. So this morning, what I do every morning before I train, I'll eat and then I look at my logbook, I look at the numbers I'm aiming for. So today, even though it's a shit morning, it's kind of cold, I'm going to hit a PV on deadlifts, 100%, because, well, I've read my book about 1,000 times. Either that or I'm going to fall over, but both fun regardless. I'll stop speaking now and stop looking at how bald the side of my head looks. Maybe I would suit a balder, let me know. Yo, so week 9 of the dieting vlog, at least I remembered that this week. Two more weeks left before we embark on the road to 100 kilos. So I was 94 at my last gaining phase. So the aim is to get to 100 with okay body comp and just see how that is. Obviously, because I'm going to push up to higher levels just to get a bit more muscle growth. So that is the aim. But with the dieting, still going well. Last week I dropped from 84.7 was the average 2 weeks ago, and then last week was 83.4. So that is quite a big drop. The only thing is the weight is a little bit off, just due to the fact of Friday I had a really low calorie day just because I was busy, so weight was down the next day. And then the Saturday, I was actually out for a drink for the first time, obviously, over lockdown, because one of my mates was home from Manchester. Normally on a dieting phase, I don't touch alcohol, but because this one's a little bit more relaxed, but because of that, my weight was down the next day, so it wasn't fully accurate. But still, overall, the weight, the week has been a real good drop. It's been a funny one, really, because now with
a lot of clients going back to the gym, so I train a few clients in Northern Ireland and a few clients abroad who have now been able to go back to the gym. So it was really cool getting to see, like I've been assessing videos the whole of lockdown, because as a coach, that's what you do. But it's cool getting to see people like back on a hack squat, back on a leg press, things like that. It was almost a bit surreal because I've not had it for so long. So that'll be, and obviously with gyms going back in England and on Friday or Saturday, it's going to be even better. But it's kind of a bit bittersweet because from a perspective of myself training and where I'll be working, I'll be able to train regardless. But it's a hard one for clients, and judging by obviously the guidelines on everything. So with me being out at the weekend, the guidelines were very strict and it almost ruins it a bit, which is understandable. But from what I'm hearing from gyms here, it could be that people only have 45 minutes to 1 hour time slots. And if you're anything like me, it takes me half an hour to warm up. So I think it's going to be a bit bittersweet in terms of the excitement for the gyms are opening. All the clients, all my clients will have their programs, and yes, we're going to be focusing on the goals. But if there's really strict guidelines, you're not allowed to do certain movements, you only have a certain time slot, it means that, yes, you're transitioning from training at home with less equipment, you're going to somewhere with more equipment, but it can be quite hard to program that. And it can also be quite stressful for people because the gym is the people's escape, isn't it? It's like they're where they go to get away from the real world. So I think it actually might be really difficult, and I'm not looking forward to sort of trying that out when it does happen. Not looking forward to trying to do a hack squat with a mask on either, but the less said about that, the better. Yeah, as I said, this week I went out Saturday with my mates, just good crack. I'll throw up a photo or something. Nice to let the hair down. If anyone's ever been to Dundee, don't ever go to McDaniel's. And with the dieting, it's been going real smooth. So as I said, another drop, but visually good. There's no changes been made. Well, no changes that week. What I've now done this week is cardio's went up a little bit. And the reason is, so out the whole process, my recovery has still been pretty much spot on. But now I'm noticing that like my lower back recovery has not been that great, and my lower body recovery has not been great. So before I was doing 80 minutes cardio, and I was doing like hit on the spin bike, but with quite a heavy gear. So my sprints were quite a high gear, but my legs just weren't handling it and the recovery was short. So I've pushed up the cardio to 120 minutes and I'm going at more of a, just a steady pace. So a little bit lighter on the gear, keeping the heart rate higher rather than it going up and down. Let's hope that works a bit better. And I'm kind of being a bit more, not smart when I train, but I'm deciding as I go. So like, for example, the big movements I do throughout a week. So I do a barbell row, that doesn't really affect it too much, but I do deadlifts and I also do a spider bar squat. But my recovery was just getting a bit hammered, and then it was moving into the rest of the week. So I've just pulled a few sets down elsewhere just to help with that. And that's something that you shouldn't really ever be scared to do in a dieting phase. You shouldn't be scared to pull back, because the quality I'll be putting in the, like, I'll be totally perfect. So that's going to maintain the tissue and keep me in a good position. But I'm not just doing stupid amounts of like sets that are a bit scrappy, and I'm not really able to do just down to me being fucked. So that is the big changes there. I've also just make sure that I'm kind of putting my steps up a little bit on my upper and non-training day, but on my lower, I'm actually keeping them a little bit lower than where they were. I just find that's better on my recovery as well. But going into this week, I'm looking at, well, my weight this morning was also down, so I'm looking at another new low. It's quite funny because I'm not that far off what weight I was on stage last year, but I look totally different because obviously I had different compounds in. My weight last year started to come back up due to adding in different drugs, but it is, well, and I don't have a tan, so that's a big one, but another couple of weeks of just digging away, and then I'm going to be starting with a new coach, which will be fucking cool and just really interesting. So the last week has really been good, especially with clients now starting to get excited and stuff, and it is great, but it just does not worry me. I'm quite a relaxed guy, but it is playing on my mind that I'm like, people will come in, they'll be super motivated, and then they might basically just be like told about all the guidelines there is. So it seems as well that my clients in Belfast, that there doesn't really seem to be any guidelines in training. Like, you can train as long as you want. There's no booking system. You can't move stuff around. Like, you couldn't move a bench to a cable machine, but there doesn't really seem to be much guidelines. One of my clients was in Italy the past week, and where she was training, it was the same. But I've got another client who's in Poland at the moment, and he was saying there's a bit more, well, where he is in, anyway, the gym he's training has a little bit more like stipulations. And I can imagine it in Scotland and England being, unless you're in bodybuilding gyms, if you're in a more commercial gym, I can imagine it being a bit difficult. And that's going to take a while to adapt and get used to. Don't worry, Phil, I'll have that sorted. I'll program it out. As well, with this week, I'm going to pull down calories just a little bit, nothing too crazy. I'll just pull down my lower and upper body days slightly, just from carbs. My appetite's actually not really that high, so it's not really that difficult, to be honest. I can just pull some carbs out my last meal, so my final meal, I'll just pull some out there, or switch one of the carb sources so it's less carbs, but still not like super high, so that's easy enough. The other changes I'm going to make, as said, are just pulling the volume down completely. Well, not completely, but pulling down across the week. One of my training days is an upper body, but I've just switched it to predominantly arms, because that's where it should have been anyway. It's just that it was quite hard with the limited equipment. So it's just arms now. What I was finding was hitting the additional chest movements was then impacting when I got back rim to chest. And I just don't think I need them at the moment. So, and it was doing the same movement pattern over and over, because I only have a Smith and a barbell. Just wasn't helping, like a few different things. So that's getting pulled down. And what else is going on? I've got a client shoot next week, which will be really cool. She checked in today, looking unbelievable. So that is more of a like lifestyle shoot, but it looks super good, real good abs. And then I've got another couple of clients who are a month out, who checked in today as well, looking, two guys looking unbelievable. So it's good now that we're just starting to roll back into that, where after, well, next week is one shoot, and then from there there's like 8 or 9 left for the year. So it's always spot on with that. A few clients reversing out of dieting phases, looking great as well. So from a business standpoint, it's going real well. And from a client standpoint, it's more just from a situation of wondering what the hell Nicola Sturgeon will be like with the guidelines in gyms, because I can imagine my head getting a little bit nipped from a lot of clients asking me what they should do if they can only train for an hour. But I suppose we'll just see what that's like when it happens. On top of that, I'm waiting to go do some work. So any questions, as usual, drop me a message on Instagram, or head over to the website and you can drop me an email. Also head over to the website to check out all of our articles, and check out the physique formula, which is really good. If you want to sign up for that, you get a 5-part email series, which will be really helpful for getting back to the gyms. I've got an article going up tomorrow. Well, today's Monday, but when the vlog goes up tomorrow. And I've also got a few posts this week that you can have a check out, especially the shot that went up on Tuesday of my client Matt, who is a month out from his shoot, looking sick. So any questions, any feedback, anything you want me to discuss next week, please drop me a message. What I'll do is, on the last week of the vlog, or last week before I transition into back to a gaining phase, I'll go through the sort of breakdown of where I started and where I ended up, with calories, cardio, weight, training, everything like that. Peace out.